Here's dessert. Yum. It's pure yogurt. So it's here in Mexico, it's Danone. And in it, I put some pecans and some chocolate chips. I guess I can work out the carbs. But let's see. Oh yeah, yum. Oh, this is so good. The yogurt itself apparently has 7 grams of carbs per 100. That's about a cup, maybe a little more. And again, the chocolate chips obviously have quite a bit of sugar in them, but there's not that many in there. And the pecans are just really good. So that's dessert, but I did wind up eating 4 scrambled eggs. With and I took the broccoli and I kind of chopped it. Now, by the way, broccoli is 4 grams of net carbs per 100 grams. So I don't know how much broccoli I ate, but I did cut up all the stems, fry them up in some butter, some salt, pepper, and then I took cheese and I melted it and scraped it and threw it over the top. That went over my eggs, and then I had my steak on brokery. There's quite a bit of broccoli in that, and obviously a lot of steak. So, I mean, I really ate a lot of food. But carb load? Seriously, I'll have to like double check. I think it's, I probably had 25, maybe 30 chips or whatever. I'm just trying to think how many, and half of that sugar, so. If it hit 10 carbs, I think I'm pretty good. Like I said, the yogurt is about 7 grams of carbs because it's just unfortunately slightly descremada, not low fat, but like too fat yogurt. But they don't add, and I mean, it just has the 7% apparently of sugars, but they do add the bacteria culture. So, and protein. So yogurt does have protein in it. But obviously no sugar. I mean, it has 2 ingredients, milk and the bugs. And then, hang on a second. I mean, I told him I was recording, but I said, go about your business, but don't, you know. Either way, I just kind of wanted to finish this out. Yeah, that's all I've had today. So I would imagine that maybe my total carb intake today was 20%. 20 grams total, just guesstimating. But again, what I really know where it was carb heavy is the chocolate chips and the broccoli and everything else. And like I said, I use soy sauce, but I only used a quarter, sorry, an eighth cup of soy sauce for, I want to say, yeah, about 3 pounds of meat and the broccoli. So, and I don't know what you guys think about the flavor of broccoli, but for me, it's super, super sweet. Now, I mean, I bit into it, and I'm like, whoa. I mean, I can taste the sugars and the stuff, you know? But anyway, it's all good. I won't need to eat again until tomorrow. So I will let you guys go. Again, what can I tell you? Caveat emptor, you have to take your own health into your own hands. I'm sorry. I personally can't trust anybody anymore. And the only people I can trust is people whom I've followed and have proved on my own body that it works. So, ta-da! This is just kind of sort of what works. So, you just, what did I ultimately do? And I'm going to repeat it until people kind of get sick of it. You know what? I'm so excited about this. I think I'm gonna get some big lonas with my picture, my former picture from May, when I was on the diet, standard diet for 6 months, 7, 8, 9 months, although I had plateaued after 3 months and could not lose the gut, couldn't lose the pudgy face. And I'm gonna hang those lonas up. I'm gonna go right downtown to my Mexican city center, and I'm gonna grab a microphone. I'm gonna start preaching. you know what? I'm going to see how many people I can save. And people here in Mexico, they just say, eh, whatever, and they'll walk by. Or they'll sit and listen to you. And I'll put out a little, you know, collection can. I'm not stupid. I'll see if I can make a, you know, a couple of pesos from my time in trouble. I'll have some handouts for folks. And essentially, all I'm going to say is, get rid of your sugar. Get rid of your grains. Tortillas is going to be a tough one. Beans and rice are going to be tough ones. But you know, what do you want? Every other guisado is good. I actually made a tamale out of almond flour. So, and when you wrap it in the corn husk, I put them both side by side and tasted them. In fact, I preferred the texture of the almond flour tamale than I did to the corn masa. It was, and there was no difference in taste. It had the lard, it had the corn husk, it had the adequate amount of salt. Yum, man. Seriously, yum. And again, the fillings are almost always keto. So again, grains. All right, so sugar, grains, and then seed oils. I've got to get these people off Nutrioli and canola and all these corn oils and vegetable oils, because there's not a drop of vegetable in them. Actually, they're seeds, and they have to be super duper ultra very extra processed. And then of course the refined foods. The biggest other thing that most Mexicans will not appreciate is literally their alcohol. I mean, you go to a party and that's what you're gonna find, and their stinking Coca-Cola. So again, I think just knocking off refined foods, Coca-Cola, and sugar alone, and then of course frying with what Mexicans always used to fry with, lard, butter, and olive oil, and they might be able to get away with a tortilla or two and maybe a little scoop of rice and some beans. I've even eaten those, and I haven't knocked myself out of ketosis. You just can't go nuts over it. And definitely eat heavy on the meat. But we'll see. So anyway, that's kind of how I want to do that. Sounds like something worthwhile. We'll see how it goes. Who knows? Can one person change the world? Yeah, a boy here. He changed the world. You know, if I can help people live a little, maybe if not longer on Earth, at least more in balance with less pain. I think it's a good goal. We'll see you soon. Bye.